for about 2 months, students were not going to school because government wanted to combat COVID-19. And now the Ministry of Secondary and Basic Education insisted that only those in the examination classes will go to school. And looking at the curriculum, the ministers went for to extend the school year, meaning that it was already a means of preparing the minds of our students psychologically and emotionally. So that the lecturers or the primary school and secondary school teachers who did not cover the scheme of work could meet up within this time given by the minister who have extended the time. And I want to also say that during the period of teaching, using the computer, using the television, visual learning, especially in primary schools and secondary schools, it was not that effective. Why? Because many students also, especially in primary school and secondary school, will not even understand the time when if primary six is having a class, an English class at this time, they will not be aware even. There was no informat to give them awareness on this. So many children miss their lectures on television. And there are some children without televisions in their homes. How do they even learn? How do this group of students learn without television?
That just tells how that some Cameroonians are still living below
poverty rate. To tell us that most Cameroonians, especially in the rural areas, are living below the poverty rate. Even in urban centers, they are living in slums, they are suffering. They could not even afford for internet. And that's why some parents who are well-to-do, the parents who fall in the middle class, some even paid teachers, and they came and taught their children at home. Not everybody could do that. So what we are saying here is that COVID-19 has taught Cameroonians that, especially the government, that we must also spend a lot in education in this country. We must spend in education in this country in terms of technology, because times have changed. There are countries that even in primary school, they learn wireless. They learn via internet and softwares. So our government expenditure must go in education. We should buy quality our school system should be wireless so that children can have access to internet. And the internet even is very expensive. The Ministry of Telecommunication and all these MTN networks, they need to work together and moderate the bundles so that children can work, and Human resource management is needed in our schools. Not all lecturers, not all teachers have the skills to transmit, to teach through visual learning.
Okay.
And there are many tools to learn. There are many softwares. We now talk on Google Classroom. Not every teacher understands what is Google Classroom, the procedures to teach and give notes and discuss with your students through Google Classroom, and even upload notes and assignments, and even collect assignments through Google Classroom. That's human resource management. We need in-service training. We need materials, we need resources to train the teachers to understand, and students to understand Google Classroom, to understand other teaching like Zoom. There's a visual learning, visual conferencing learning, Zoom, Skype. So COVID-19 also has its advantages to tell us that COVID-19 is not only disadvantage. We know that it's disadvantageous because many people have lost their lives.
Yes.
But COVID-19 has brought in an issue of reawakening.
That we are behind.
We are behind. Civilization started in Africa, but Africa is not enlightened in technology. So COVID-19 has brought the attention of government that we need to reawaken ourselves. So in our school system of today, we need a lot of human resource management through training. So government expenditure must go into education to train teachers, to train students on how to use visual learning tools, especially the Google Classroom, the Zoom, and not only training on them on that, the resources must be available for the training to be efficient. Not every child can afford for a flexible mobile phone. Not every child can afford for a laptop. So we are leaving behind. So not all teachers also are technologically educated. What of teachers who are good only in face-to-face teaching? What of teachers who are not Android teachers? How would they teach in such periods? So most teachers did not cover their scheme of work.
Yes.
So that's why the minister had to extend the time of the examination, and only exam students had to go back to school. And they said they'll promote students based on their first term report cards.
But Doc, before I come to you, Mr. Njomo Siri, you are a lecturer in the University of Boya.
Yes.
Okay, those who were caught.